first and 10, wants it all. Deep over the middle for Winicky, has it inside the 10.
Still with it, Diana Powerhouse!
Ilfil Velez on the run, diving in the alley.
It's Alexander with a nice move, goes to the rim, got it to go!
Hi, friends, and welcome to the Jackrabbit Insider. I'm Tyler Merriam, and it's great to have you with us as we kick off Hobo Week and the homecoming football game coming up on Saturday against Youngstown State. Speaking of football, John Stiglmeyer in studio as we recap North Dakota State. The Dakota Marker Contest was yesterday in the Fargo Dome. Our senior student athlete spotlight is on a safety from Milbank, Nick Mears, and we'll look at the SDSU soccer team atop the Summit League. But we talked about men's basketball last week. This week, let's shift our focus to the Jackrabbit women, who have won the Summit League title in seven of the past eight seasons. And Aaron Johnston's squad is hungry for more.
It's been good. You can see we've got some good veteran returning leadership sprinkled in with a bunch of newcomers, a couple of freshmen, a couple of transfers. Things that we're trying to get down in practice seem like they're familiar ideas, and that comes from that, you know, big group of returning players.
Not only do the Jacks return all five starters from last year, but each of those players was recognized as preseason all-conference. Mitchell native Macy Miller was voted the player of the year. The junior guard led the team in scoring last year, averaging 15.5 points. Last year's defensive player of the year in the league, Clarissa Ober, was also a first-team preseason pick. She led the squad in rebounds and blocks. Ellie Thompson is also a first-team pick. She shot 47% overall and 38 from deep a season ago. Guards Kerry Young and Madison Giebert were second-teamers. Also from Mitchell, Young tallied 10.5 points a game while shooting 42% overall and 83 at the charity stripe. Giebert buried 83 threes last season, earning Summit League Freshman of the Year honors. Lots of talent returns, but Johnston is adamant that the team not be content with last year's success.
Well, really, we challenged all five of those players to be better coming back this year. And so the simple idea of returning five starters, that's true, that doesn't mean they're all going to be starters now. They've got to work hard, and they've got things they need to show to us. We've talked about moving some of them around in different positions, and I think that has really forced them to grow, I think, as players and us as a team. So we return a lot of experience, but this is a new year, and they'll be asked to do a lot of new things.
Alexis Alexander averaged 18 minutes per game in the backcourt, while now sophomores Sydney Palmer and Jessica Miris and junior Tiffany Flotta each contributed in limited time a year ago. And they'll vie for playing time this year with two incoming freshmen, forward Sydney Tracy and center Megan Boltsema.
I'm excited about our new players. Sydney Tracy is just a really versatile wing player from Minnesota. She fits our traditional 6'1", really versatile, inside-outside, good defensive player, good rebounder, and she'll add a lot of depth to our perimeter spot right away. And Megan Boltsema here from South Dakota has been just a real presence for us inside. She's all a 6'3 and long. She gets rebounds that no one else on our team can get to. Still runs the floor really well, getting more comfortable playing away from the basket. So both of those two we expect to help us here right away.
Not only do the Jacks return five starters who are all top players, but Johnston reminds us they are versatile.
Like this year, we're able to use Macy, for instance, at a 1-2 or a 3. We're able to use Carey at a 2-3 or a 4. Sydney Palmer at a 2-3 or 4. Maddie as a 1 or 2. Ellie has been playing 5 and 4. So really, we've been very interchangeable, which I think will help us throughout the year. I also think this year's team offensively is very talented. They have the ability to score points. They have a lot of players that can make plays, so I don't think we'll be reliant on any one or two players to carry us. And I think because of our length, hopefully we can be good defensively again, challenging shots, rebounding, getting out in some passing lanes, just using that length that we have on the perimeter and inside.
The first exhibition game is October 27th, while the regular season opens on November 11th, as Creighton comes to Frost Arena to tip off the year. And with some of the names on the schedule, it's another grind in the non-conference for AJ and the program.
Yeah, our non-conference will be a big challenge. We start off with tough ones, whether it's Creighton or going down to an Iowa tournament right away. After that, we've got Oklahoma. Shortly after that, we'll see Louisville. We'll see some of the best teams around. Great series going on with Green Bay. Great series going on with UNI, these teams we've traditionally played. We have George Washington this year, who's always been very good. NCAA tournament type team. Bowling Green's been a very good mid major. And so we'll definitely be tested, and that's good. You know, so far it hasn't backfired on us. We've always been able to overcome some of those challenges and make it a productive year. So we're excited about that. We think we've got a very good team, and we're excited to see how we do against some other really good teams.
rather lofty goals and aspirations for Aaron Johnston and the Jackrabbit women. The SDSU football team vied for the Dakota Marker at North Dakota State on Saturday afternoon. Highlights and Coach John Stiglmeyer in studio after you go inside state.
If I were to make my own SDSU ice cream, I'd probably make a birthday cake ice cream. A little bit of sprinkles on top with some cake batter in there, it'd be delicious. My name is Amy Hankins and I'm from Belle Plaine, Minnesota. There's so many reasons why I chose SDSU. I wanted to go here because, you know, 3 hours isn't too far away from home, but it's close enough that I can get home when I want to. It has more of a small town feel to it, but it is still a big school. You can get to know anybody that you want to know and get involved in anything that you want to get involved in. Sophomore year, I decided, you know, I kind of want to break out from that shell a little bit. I decided to get involved in Greek life, and that really expanded my horizons on getting to know people, getting involved on campus. It's probably been the best decision that I've made coming here to SDSU. There's so many things to do for fun around here. Brookings is a growing community. There's always something going on, especially around campus. There's usually movies, football games, basketball games, those kinds of things. Grabbing coffee at Einstein's with all my friends. We just like to hang out while we're doing homework. I'm just hanging out with friends on campus. I think SDSU is best known for our Jackrabbit Pride. During the football games and the basketball games, the whole sections are usually filled up with fans who are cheering for them. It's just great knowing that, you know, I go to a school where everybody supports our Jackrabbits.
On second and short, they'll play action, and here's the pressure, and Danny Batten's got Walker, and he's trapped at midfield.
Listen up. This is the time, this is the place, and this is Ford F-150, the truck that goes toe-to-toe with your life. Made of high-strength, military-grade aluminum alloy, it pulled the highest safety rating the government can give. And with Pro Trailer Backup Assist, it's like having your head on a swivel, pal. So load up your crew. This is the time.
Now get up to $10,395 in total savings or lease an F-150 for just $279 a month. Visit your local Northland Ford dealer today.
How did we become the region's largest independent seed company? By taking a very simple but powerful stand. We will sell no seed that we wouldn't be happy to plant on our own farm. Peterson Farm Seed. Stand tall.
Being part of a great team means you know your role and you work your role to the best of your ability. If you're consistently going to show up and be your best, you're going to be part of that team. You can see the success they have over time. It's not just 1 year flash in the pan. It's consistent success over time, which makes them great. And that's where the work ethic comes in. The ability to come into work, do the same thing repeatedly, day after day after day, and putting your best foot forward is going to separate you from the rest.
Choose the experts. Choose Sanford Orthopedics and Sports Medicine.
This portion of the Jackrabbit Insider is brought to you by Sanford Orthopedics and Sports Medicine. Expert care when you need it.
Welcome back. John Stiglmeyer with us, the head football coach of the Jacks. To say he's happy would be an understatement. It's been a long wait, but after 8 in a row, 6 for the Dakota Marker, that marker is now back in the Mount Rushmore State after Saturday's win at North Dakota State.
Yeah, you know, just to get the win. The trophy, the marker is kind of the frosting, if you will, but to go on the road, the Missouri Valley, play the number one team in the nation and get the win in a tough environment with some tough calls, I'm really proud of our team.
There was a lot that happened on Saturday. Let's have a look at some of the highlights. There is the Dakota Marker trophy that's at stake in this rivalry between the Jacks and Bison. SDSU marches all the way down to the 1 yard line in the opening series, but on fourth and goal, Taryn Christian's pass is too high for Dallas Goddard. The Bison respond by going 99 yards, and on fourth and goal, Easton Stick, the quarterback, keeps and scores 7-0 Bison. Late in the second quarter, Chase Vinatieri connects on this 38 yard field goal, but Bison kicker Cam Peterson, good from 49 on the last play of the half, 10-3. 3 NDSU at the break. Early in the third, Stick runs in from 26 yards out. Bison have the Jacks up against it at 17-3. But SDSU responds. Taryn Christian hits Dallas Goddard. The 12-yard touchdown makes it 17-10. Early in the fourth, Vinatieri hits the second field goal from 42 yards. That made it 17-13. And on fourth down, with just 1 second remaining in the game, Jake Winicky catches this two-yarder from Christian, and South Dakota State regains the marker, a 19-17 victory.
So many things to digest in this football game, but let us begin with that final drive. 15 plays, 80 yards, and 2 minutes and 27 seconds. Had a penalty, had a first and 20, and had to overcome that in the middle of the drive. And then obviously with 1 second left, Jake Winicky makes the touchdown catch from Taryn Christian. But that drive, again, that's a game and season-defining drive for your program.
Well, you know, you practice two-minute drill every week, and in many games you don't get to use it. And in this case, we got to use it, and we executed pretty well. The holding call on Oney was a tough one. That was a tough block he had to make. It was holding, and we were able to respond to that. A lot of things about this game talk about or define how we handle adversity, and I thought we did a great job.
To that point, three times you marched inside the Bison 5-yard line in this game and came away with no points. You had two fourth downs that you couldn't convert, and then you had an interception in the end zone as well. So you moved up and down the field on NDSU, but those missed opportunities in the red zone could have proved costly in this game.
Well, they sure could have, and it would have been a shame had they proved costly. You know, we were going to be aggressive in the football game, and anytime you ask, you know, it's my call, but anytime you ask, everybody wants to go for it. And, you know, the cool thing is we didn't play in the past. We didn't hang our heads. We didn't talk about not getting it. We just kept forging ahead and trying to make plays.
We talked about it after the SIU victory, that down the stretch it was your defense that cemented that win, even though your offense earned all the headlines. In this game, after the Bison took a 17-3 lead on the opening drive of the third quarter, you forced a fumble and four punts on the next five drives, held them to 81 yards over the last 25 minutes of football. Your defense came up huge in the second half.
Well, it's huge, and really the fourth quarter, we just, our defense was stifling. I think they had 18 yards in the fourth quarter. Now, part of that is our time of possession, moving the ball, but great job by Coach Brown and his staff. Again, our guys, we claim we want to be a physical football team. We were a physical football team Saturday.
To that point, 220 rushing yards, 6 yards a carry. This is a team in NDSU that had allowed 101 total rushing yards in the previous three games. You had that by halftime. You were gashing the Bison on the ground.
Well, they did, again, a great game plan, using Taryn, spreading things out. Our fullback did a great job of blocking in those one back plays with Taryn running. Our running backs got some good yards, but again, it starts with the fat guys battling a really good North Dakota defensive line and really winning the battle.
You mentioned Taryn Christian, 20 rushes for 141 yards. He is the first SDSU quarterback since 1988, Ted Wall at North Dakota, to rush for 100 yards. But more importantly, that defensive line I want to hit on, or that offensive line rather, I want to hit on that again. The way that they controlled the line of scrimmage against one of, if not the best defensive line in the Missouri Valley Football Conference was something else.
I thought they did a great job, and not only with running the ball, we're talking about running the ball, but pass blocking. You know, they got two really good defensive ends, good tackles, and Taryn got sacked once by a linebacker. So really, really good job by those guys. And I really think they're getting better every week. Coach Eck is doing an amazing job.
Speaking of guys that seemingly get better every week, we can throw Dallas Goddard and Jake Winicky into this discussion. Goddard, 11 catches for 150. Winicky, 6 for 108 and the game winner. And you look at some of the big plays that were made. I mean, Goddard was almost impossible to tackle on Saturday, and Winicky had another one-handed catch.
Yeah, they're just special, special players. And again, it starts with the fat guys. Taryn's comfortable in the pocket. I think one of the biggest catches in the game was Adam Anderson's catch over on the sidelines to keep that two-minute drive going. But everybody rose up, and those two guys are special players.
One final point about your offense. This is a Bison team, a Bison program that's so well known for defense, much like your program has been. And it's the first time in the Division I era, first time since at least 98, the Bison have not forced a punt. Brady Hale didn't even need to come on the trip to Fargo on Saturday.
Well, we did have a fourth down. We went went for, you know, in the 40-yard area that we probably should have punted. That was a little risky. But again, we went into the game wanting to be aggressive. I'm just so proud of our football team, whether it's special teams, offense, defense. That's a tough environment to play in, and our guys did a great job of competing. And I think they made a mark. They made a statement.
Huge win, but no time to rest because there were three teams that were undefeated in the Valley when Saturday started. Now there's two. The other one besides your program is coming to Brookings on Saturday, Youngstown State. And, of course, it's Hobo Day and all the excitement of what will be a first-place showdown Saturday afternoon.
Well, we talk about Hobo Week because there's so many things going on, and we like that for the student body and for the alums and so on. But our job is at 2 o'clock on Saturday for the Hobo Day game. And Youngstown's a good football program. Coach Pliny's done a nice job. He's got them going again, and we need to be ready to play our best ball.
2 o'clock on Saturday afternoon, the Jacks host the Penguins on Hobo Day. Tickets available at jackrabbittickets.com. Time now for this week's Jackrabbit Legend.
Adam Vinatieri is the most famous kicker to come out of South Dakota State. The most decorated place kicker in SDSU history is this week's Jackrabbit Legend, Parker Douglas, presented by Legend Seeds. There was some confusion at first as to whether his name was Parker Douglas or if it was actually Douglas Parker. But from his debut as a freshman in 2004, Douglas made sure his name would never be forgotten by Jackrabbit fans, and he annihilated the SDSU kicking records during his time. In fact, he holds or shares 19 different marks. Douglas was an All-American as a sophomore in 2005 and was voted the Great West Conference Special Teams Player of the Year in both 05 and 06. He had a string of 13 consecutive field goals made, and his 57-yard field goal versus Stephen F. Austin in 2007 is the longest ever banged through by a Jackrabbit. Douglas connected on 62 field goals in his career, which nearly doubled the previous mark. He had 135 of his 138 extra point tries and scored 321 points in all. Parker Douglas, a Jackrabbit legend. This Jackrabbit legend is presented by Legend Seeds, your regional seed leader.
Being part of a great team means you know your role and you work your role to the best of your ability. If you're consistently going to show up and be your best, you're going to be part of that team. You can see the success they have over time. It's not just 1 year flash in the pan. It's consistent success over time, which makes them great. And that's where the work ethic comes in. The ability to come into work, do the same thing repeatedly, day after day after day, and putting your best foot forward is going to separate you from the rest.
Choose the experts. Choose Sanford Orthopedics and Sports Medicine.
Get ready for the Hefties Fan PhD Tip of the Week, encouraging you to get up, get loud, and get involved, and give the Jackrabbits a hometown advantage.
This year was fantastic. I got my best yields ever.
Record yields start by putting the best seed in the ground. At Hefty, we not only pick the best genetics and traits for you, but we have the most stringent seed grower specs in the industry. That means higher yields for you.
We're Hefties! And we're big on the farm.
Hefty brand soybeans. Agronomy, answers, yield.
Hey, Jacks fans, I know this is remedial, but when we're on offense, be locked in, but be quiet, please. When the opponent is on offense, be locked in, but be as loud as you can be.
This week's fan tip was brought to you by Hefty's Fan PhD, helping Jackrabbit fans go from good to great.
Great to have you with us this week on The Insider. From Milbank, South Dakota, a state champion quarterback, to an excellent safety at South Dakota State University. Here's the tale of Nick Mears in our senior student athlete spotlight.
In high school, I mostly played quarterback. I didn't really play a whole lot of defense, so it was nice that SDSU gave me a shot to play defense here.
We saw a guy that understood football. We saw a guy that could run and wasn't afraid to hit. And that's what you look for in a safety. And so that's what we made him, and he's had a great career.
Mears was all-state as both a punter and QB at Milbank High. He threw for 4,595 yards and 58 touchdowns, while running for another 3,000 yards and 34 scores. The Bulldogs won a state title with Mears barking out signals as a sophomore, and he was also an excellent track athlete, in addition to being an academic all-state honoree and a member of the National Honor Society.
Well, I think Nick Mears represents many, many Jackrabbits, guys that grew up wanting to be a Jackrabbit, small town South Dakota, and we're lucky to have him because he's a great student athlete. He's an unbelievable leader, and I couldn't be happier with Nick Mears.
You know, playing for the state's best university too, I mean, it doesn't get much better than that either, and I'm definitely glad I came here. I mean, just the atmosphere here and everything about the program really is great.
Mears saw limited time as a freshman but made a significant impact as a sophomore. He was second on the squad with 96 tackles, starting 11 of 13 games. He made 54 tackles in 9 starts last year and was poised for a big senior season, but the path had a detour in the first quarter of the opener at TCU.
TCU, I just went down and filled a gap, and the guy kind of got away, and then Langer just kind of rolled up on me, and I mean, it was just, if it would happen again, I mean, I wouldn't think anything of it. It was just a football play. It's just casual. I mean, I think I've suffered worse here for sure. It's just this thing just kind of lingers a little bit and just twisted my foot up a little bit.
It forced him to miss the rest of that game and the next two. Frustrating for anyone, particularly a senior and team captain.
It's tough. I mean, everybody wants to be out there and contributing and playing. It's always frustrating to deal with injuries. And, you know, for my first few years here, I was lucky to not be hurt a whole lot. And, you know, at the end of last year, I kind of dinged my knee up, and now beginning of this year, my foot. So, I mean, it really makes you thankful for the health that you do have. So, you know, it's just kind of the thing where you just got to stay locked in and, you know, like, just keep encouraging the guys and everything.
You know, when Nick was out, he still had an impact on our football team. You know, he wasn't on the field, but he was leading in the sidelines. He was leading at practice. He was coaching the young safeties. And so, really, he wasn't hanging his head, which is a really, really neat sign of a winner. And so, on the field or off, he impacts the Jackrabbits.
Mears is an economics major, and he'll graduate in December. So what's the future look like for him?
Oh, that's a tough question. My parents would like a good answer on that one too, I guess. But I'm going to have to really start buckling down on that. But, you know, eventually I want to go to grad school. I think I'll probably work right away this coming spring. Then I'll start, you know, applying for grad school and everything, and then we'll see where it goes from there.
Mears will lead the South Dakota State football team on the field against Youngstown State Saturday afternoon, Hobo Day, 2 o'clock the kickoff at Dana J. Dykal Stadium. Now, this week's Jackrabbit Hot Seat.
I'm Krista Steele from Monticello, Minnesota. I'm a health education major, and I'm in cross country and track. Favorite movie is definitely Harry Potter. I just recently started getting into the books, and then I really started watching the movies, and I just really enjoyed it. My favorite athlete I most admire is Lori Hernandez. She was on the Olympic team for gymnastics, and I just really loved her personality and how well she does as an athlete. If I had to pick between cross country or track, I would choose track because I'm an 800 runner, so it's only 2 laps. The best part I like about Brookings is probably the community. They're so involved with Jackrabbits, and it's actually really inspiring. The reason I chose SDSU, I really like the coach, and on my recruiting visits, I really liked all the girls here. They're all really nice and opening and welcoming, and I love the track facility that we have here as well.
Coming up, a recap of the SDSU soccer team's success in the Summit League to date. But first, a look back at Dan Feldheim's aerial assault on Minnesota State Mankato from 2001.
Farmers are paying more attention to water quality and making it a priority.
Every farm is different. And every farmer is different, but everyone wants to do what's right for the environment. We're conserving the water, the limited water that we do get, and we're not wasting it.
The individual farmer has to be proactive.
No-till allows our crops to use all the water that we are blessed to receive.
We keep water clean.
For the people of South Dakota, it's about doing the right thing.
I am Al Miron.
Steve Halverson.
Jeff Lochner.
This is Farming.
The
listen up.
This is the time, this is the place, and this is Ford F-150, the truck that goes toe-to-toe with your life. Made of high-strength, military-grade aluminum alloy, it pulled the highest safety rating the government can give. And with Pro Trailer Backup Assist, it's like having your head on a swivel, pal. So load up your crew. This is the time.
Now get up to $10,395 in total savings or lease an F-150 for just $279 a month. Visit your local Northland Ford dealer today.
The Jackrabbit Insider is brought to you by the Hefty Seed Company, Agronomy, Answers, Yield. Your local Northland Ford dealers. Visit northlandford.com or your local dealer. Sanford Orthopedics and Sports Medicine. Expert care when you need it. The University Bookstore. Shop now at jackrabbitcentral.com. South Dakota Corn. This is Farming. Proud sponsor of the South Dakota Showdown Series. And by South Dakota State University. Be great. Start here.
The Insider continues. We spend so much time talking about the success year in, year out of football, men's and women's basketball. But sometimes it's forgotten about that one of the most consistent programs SDSU has is Lang Wiedemeyer's Jackrabbit soccer program. And surprise, surprise, they're atop the Summit League again in 2016.
Oh, absolutely. Certainly anytime you can start this way is a positive, but we know that we're not done yet. We haven't really accomplished our goals. We've got a lot yet to prove and some really tough games ahead of us.
Last weekend, the Jacks dominated two home games in conference play. A 2-0 win over Western Illinois last Friday was followed by a 5-1 trouncing of Oral Roberts Sunday. It also led to the team's fourth individual Athlete of the Week award. Sioux Falls native Nicole Hatcher, a junior from Roosevelt High School, was Offensive Player of the Week in the Summit League. She scored two goals and added two assists during the dominant weekend sweep.
We always knew that she was capable of these types of numbers and this type of play, and it was a lot about just getting her to recognize and have a confidence and almost selfishness to try to make some things happen. And as she's finding a great balance between creating chances for herself and setting her teammates up.
Soccer's in the midst of a three-game conference road swing. They were at rivals USD Friday and North Dakota State earlier today, and will head south on I-29 to play Omaha on Friday. Next Sunday, the Jacks host Denver, and then the regular season finale is just 12 days away, as SDSU will host IUPUI on Friday the 28th. So how does this team finish strong as advised for its third straight trip to the NCAA College Cup?
Well, I think it's a lot about our players' intensity and training on a daily basis, confidence, but also staying humble and hungry and wanting more and recognizing we still have a lot of that to accomplish.
Thanks for joining us this week. The largest one-day event in the Dakotas is Saturday. It is Hobo Day, and it all wraps up with the Jackrabbit football game against Youngstown State at 2 o'clock at Dana J. Dykal Stadium. You can visit jackrabbittickets.com to join us. Radio coverage starts at 1 o'clock throughout our Jackrabbit Sports Network. John Stiglmeyer's in studio next week. Highlights of that and a whole lot more, so join us next time. And for all of us here inside the Yeager Media Center studios, I'm Tyler Merriam, and we'll see you on Hobo Day weekend on the Jackrabbit Insider.